Hello everyone, let us talk about next point in the spectrophotometry. So before starting the next point, what we discussed in previous lecture? In previous lecture we discussed about some interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter and their regions and what are the changes will be observed in the matter. Here we can see that the gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, visible, IR, microwave, radio waves, electron spin resonance and nuclear magnetic resonance. These are the different regions and how they can be interact with matter and what is the changes in the matter will be observed, that we discussed in previous lecture. We also discuss about some important terminologies which are used in spectrophotometry, that is called as the radiant power. Radiant power is nothing but it is the rate at which energy is transmitted as a electromagnetic radiation, that is called as a radiant power. Radiant energy is nothing but the energy transmitted as electromagnetic radiation, that is called radiant energy. It can be denoted by letter E. E is equal to h nu or sc upon lambda, where h is Planck's constant, c is velocity of light and lambda is wavelength. We also discuss about transmittance. Transmittance is nothing but it is the fraction of light which is transmitted through the sample, or it is the ratio of radiant power of incident light upon radiant power of transmitted light. Then the next term is absorbance, denoted by letter A. It is previously is also known as optical density, and it is the logarithm of base 10 to the reciprocal of transmittance, or it is the negative logarithm of base 10 to the transmittance. Then the next term is called as absorptivity. Absorptivity is also called as a extinction coefficient or extinction coefficient, and it can be denoted by letter small a. It is the ratio of absorbance to the product of path length and concentration. Then molar absorptivity can be denoted by letter epsilon, and it is the product of absorptivity to the molecular weight of the substance. And we also discuss about a path length. Path length is nothing but it is the internal diameter or thickness of the sample cell, where the absorption of the or where the sample which is taken, that is called as a path length. Then in this lecture we will be discuss about some fundamental laws which are used in photometry or the spectrophotometry. When the monochromatic light or heterochromatic light, when it will be interact with the sample cell, or we can see that sample medium, then part of the radiant power will be absorbed, part of the light will be transmitted, part of the light will be reflected, and part of the light we can see that which is transmitted to the sample, right? So this is the example where we can see that when the radiant power will interact with the sample solution, when the monochromatic light or heterochromatic light travel through the sample medium, that is medium of concentration C, then among these PA is the light which is absorbed by the sample, and P is the transmitted light, where B is the thickness of the sample, and P0 is radiant power of incident light. Then some light will be reflected, that is PR, this is the light will be reflected, right? If we see, the radiant power of incident light is the total of radiant power of reflected light, absorbed light and transmitted light. So this is the total radiant power incident light, P0, right? So what is P0? P0 is nothing but radiant power of incident light, PR is the radiant power of reflected light, PA is the radiant power of absorbed light, and P is the radiant power of transmitted light. So it means when the light, monochromatic light or heterochromatic light, is transmitted through the sample solution, then the part of light will be reflected, absorbed and transmitted. But if the comparison cell or same cell which is used during the analysis, then PR, that is radiant power of reflected light, will be small, very small, and which is nearly equal to 4%, and therefore we can eliminate these radiant power of reflected light for ear glass interference interface, and therefore under this condition P0 is nothing but PA plus P, that is amount of radiant power of absorbed light and radiant power of transmitted light. This is the total of radiant power of incident light. And according to that, two fundamental laws which can be underlined in the practice of photometry. What are these two laws? One is called as a Lambert's law, which is given by the scientist Lambert in 1716, which is gives a relationship between the radiant power of absorbed light and the thickness of the medium. That means the Lambert's law is related to the thickness of the sample medium and the absorbed light. The second law is called as a Beer's law, which is developed in 1852 and which state the relationship between the radiant power of absorbed light and the concentration of the medium. That is, Beer's law is related to the concentration of the medium. If we see the combined law, that is called as a Lambert's Beer's law. Lambert's Beer's law is related to the, it is related to the absorption of light and thickness and concentration of the medium. Let us discuss these two laws. First is called as a Lambert's law. If you see the statement of this Lambert's law, when a beam of monochromatic light is allowed to pass through a transparent medium, the rate of decrease of radiant power with thickness of the medium is directly proportional to the radiant power of incident light. What is Lambert's law? When beam of monochromatic light is allowed to pass through transparent medium, then the rate of decrease of radiant power with thickness, that is, as the thickness increases, radiant power is also decreases. If rate of decrease of radiant power with the thickness of the medium is directly proportional to the radiant power of incident light. So mathematically we can see the statement, that is, minus dp upon dB is directly proportional to P. What is P? P is called as radiant power of incident light, dB is called as a thickness, and dP is called as a decrease of radiant power, and minus sign will be denote the decrease in the radiant power. Or we can also rearrange this equation, that is, minus dP upon dB is equal to K1P, K is called as a proportionality constant, right? Where dP is the change of radiant power with the light, of radiant power P passes through the sample. Then dB and K are called as a proportionality constant, and the minus sign will indicate the radiant power decreases as the light path increases. So what is dP? dP is the change in radiant power, P is the radiant power of incident light, dB is the thickness of the medium, and K1 is called as a proportionality constant, and minus sign will indicate, that is, the radiant power will decreases, right? Then if we rearrange the equation 1, that is, minus dP upon dB is equal to K1B, then we get equation minus dP upon P is equal to K1 into dB. That means simply dB is divided, it can be multiplied, and P is multiplied, it can become divided here, right? So equation becomes minus dP upon P is equal to K1 into dB. On integrating equation between proper limits, B is equal to B0 to B, that is the thickness. Thickness will be ranging from 0 to 1, 2, 3 up to the N or up to the B, and P is nothing but P0 to P. P is radiant power of incident light, and P is nothing but radiant power of transmitted light. Then we get equation minus dP upon P integration from P0 to P is equal to integration of K1 dB from 0 to B, right? We know that integration of 1 upon P or integration of 1 upon X is nothing but ln X, right? Therefore, equation becomes minus ln P is equal to ln P from P0 to P is equal to K1 is constant and integration of dB is B. By substituting the value P0 and P in equation, therefore equation becomes, that is, minus ln of P minus ln of P0 is equal to K1 into B minus 0. And therefore, by rearranging equation, equation becomes minus ln of P upon P0 is equal to K1 into B. Then if you convert this minus sign into plus sign, then the equation becomes reverse, that is, ln of P0 upon P is equal to K1 into B, right? And therefore, by changing ln into log to the base 10, we multiply the simply value 2.303. Therefore, 2.303 into log of 10 into P0 upon P is equal to K1 into B, right? And therefore, multiply this 2.303, it becomes divide to the right hand side, and therefore, equation of log of 10 P0 upon P is equal to K1 upon 2.303 into b, right? But we know that the log of p0 upon p is nothing but absorbance, right? Log of p0 upon p is nothing but absorbance, or we know that the transmittance is equal to p upon p0, right? So minus t is equal to p0 upon p, and minus log of transmittance is nothing but absorbance, and therefore absorbance is equal to k1 into b. What is k1? K1 is nothing but k1 upon 2.303. Therefore absorbance is equal to log of 10 p0 upon p, and where k1 is called as a k1 divided by 2.303, that is absorptivity coefficient. And therefore from this Lambert's law we can say that absorbance is equal to k1 into b, that is absorbance is directly proportional to the path length of the solution, right, where k1 is constant. So this is the simple statement and derivation for the Lambert's law. Same we can also derive a Beer's law and its statement. What is Beer's law? When a beam of monochromatic light is allowed to pass through a transparent medium, the rate of decrease of radiant power with concentration of the medium is directly proportional to the radiant power of the incident light. Because Beer's law is related to the concentration of the sample solution and radiant power of incident light. Mathematically, we can write this equation as minus dp upon dc is directly proportional to the p. Minus dp upon dc is directly proportional to p, where dp is the, we can say that, change in radiant power, dc is the change in concentration, p is radiant power of incident light, and minus sign is nothing but the decrease in radiant power. Or we can also write this equation as minus dp upon dc is equal to k2 into p, where k2 is called as a proportionality constant. Therefore equation becomes minus dp upon dc is equal to k2 into p, where dp is the change in radiant power when the light of the radiant power p passes through the infinitesimally small concentration of the sample dc, right? When the sample passing through the small concentration range dc, the rate of decrease of radiant power is dp, and k2 is called as a proportionality constant, and the minus sign indicate the radiant power decreases at the light path increases, right, or the concentration increases. So this is the simple relation between radiant power of incident light and concentration of the medium. Then rearranging this equation, minus dp upon dc, rearranging this equation minus dp upon dc into k1 p, we can get equation minus dp upon p is equal to k2 into dc. So p is multiplied, becomes divided here, and dc is divided here, it can be multiplied to the right hand side. Then integrating this equation between proper limit c is equal to 0 to c and p from p0 to p, that is from radiant power incident light p0 to the total radiant power of transmitted light p and concentration from 0 to c, we get equation from p0 to p minus, that is integration of dp upon p from p0 to p is equal to integration of k2 dc from 0 to c. If we integrate this equation, then minus ln p from p0 to p is equal to k2 into c. Then substitute the value of p and p0, therefore minus ln of p minus ln of p0, right, and therefore is equal to k2 c minus 0, right, and therefore by rearranging equation becomes minus ln of p upon p0 is equal to k2 into c. Then if we revert this equation, that is ln p0 upon p is equal to k2 into c, that is the minus sign becomes plus sign when the p0 is goes to numerator and p go to denominator, then equation becomes ln of p0 upon p is equal to k2 into c, and therefore convert this ln into log to the base 10 by multiplying 2.303. Therefore 2.303 log 10 p0 upon p is equal to k2 into c. Now this 2.303 is multiplied here, it becomes divided to the right hand side, and therefore equation becomes log of p0 upon p to the base 10 is equal to k2 upon 2.303 into c, where log of base 10 to the p0 upon p is called as absorbance. It is absorbance. Absorbance is nothing but minus log of transmittance or log of 1 upon t. T is nothing but p upon p0. Therefore, log of 1 upon t is nothing but absorbance, and therefore absorbance is equal to K2 into C. That is, log of 10 P0 upon P is called as absorbance, and therefore absorbance is equal to log of 10 of P0 upon P, and K2 is called as a K2 divided by 2.303, it is called as a absorptivity coefficient, right? So this is the simple relation, or we can simply prove the mathematical statement of this Beer's law, right? So what is Lambert's law? Lambert's law is related to the path length, that is absorbance is directly proportional to the path length, and Beer's law is related to the concentration, that is absorbance is directly proportional to the concentration, right? Then Lambert's Beer's law, or we can say a combined law. Combined law, as the name suggests, this law is the combination of two laws, that is Lambert's law and Beer's law. The law deals with the relationship between the radiant power of incident light and radiant power of transmitted light as a function of both thickness of the medium and concentration of the absorbing species, and therefore the combined laws is also referred to as simply Beer's law. Either we can say that Lambert's Beer's law, or simply we can say that Beer's law. So this mathematically, this Beer's law can be given as absorbance is equal to constant into thickness of the medium into concentration of the medium. That is, absorbance is directly proportional to concentration and path length of the medium. That is, absorbance is equal to constant into B into C, when the concentration is expressed in gram per liter and thickness in centimeter, the constant is called as absorptivity. When concentration is measured in terms of gram per liter and path length in centimeter, then the absorptivity, the constant is called as absorptivity and denoted by symbol A. Therefore, absorbance is equal to A into B into C. And when the concentration is expressed in moles per liter or thickness in centimeter, then the constant is called as a molar absorptivity, and it can be related by the symbol epsilon. Therefore, absorbance is equal to epsilon B into C. Now, that is, it is simply related to the concentration. If concentration in gram per liter, it is called as absorptivity, and when concentration in moles per liter, it is called as a molar absorptivity, right? And absorbance is equal to either A into B into C or epsilon into B into C. Thus, molar absorptivity is the absorbance of solution measured in cell of 1 centimeter thickness and with the concentration of 1 mole per liter, then it is constant independent of concentration, path length of the radiant power of incident light, then absorbance is nothing but concentration. Absorbance is directly proportional to concentration, right? That means if a unit, we can say path length, for the unit path length, we can say that absorbance is directly proportional to concentration. And therefore, the statement of Lambert's Beer's law can be given as, for the given system, the thickness of the medium, the absorbance of the medium is directly proportional to the concentration of the absorbing species. So this is the combined law, that is called as the Lambert's Beer's law, or simply Beer's law. So friends, what we discussed today? We discussed two fundamental laws, that is Lambert's law and Beer's law. What is Lambert's law? When a beam of monochromatic light is allowed to pass through a transparent medium, the rate of decrease of radiant power with thickness of the medium is directly proportional to the radiant power of incident light. Mathematically, we can say that absorbance is directly proportional to the path length. That is, A is equal to K1 into B. Then Beer's law. Beer's law is related to the concentration of the medium. When a beam of monochromatic light is allowed to pass through a transparent medium, the rate of decrease of radiant power with the concentration of the medium is directly proportional to the radiant power of incident light. Mathematically, absorbance is directly proportional to concentration, or absorbance is equal to K2 into C. K2 is called as a constant, or the absorptivity constant. Or the combined law, Lambert's and Beer's law. The combined law, Lambert's and Beer's law, is nothing but the absorbance is directly proportional to the path length and concentration, and when concentration is expressed in gram per liter, it is called as absorptivity, constant is called as absorptivity, therefore absorbance is equal to A into B into C. When concentration is expressed in terms of moles per liter, then constant is expressed in terms of molar absorptivity, that is epsilon, therefore absorbance is equal to E into B into C, that is epsilon into path length into concentration. Then for a unit path length, the combined law is also called as a Lambert's Beer's law, or it is also called as a simply a Beer's law. And his statement, for the given system and the thickness of the medium, the absorbance of the medium is directly proportional to the concentration of an absorbing species. That is, when V is equal to 1, absorbance is directly proportional to concentration. So friends, we can stop here. The remaining part we will be discussing next lecture. Thank you.